first pick up a pen to draw, or a pencil?
This was when I was in Minneapolis with a wonderful art teacher, and she was the inspiration for everything, because I, up until then, my life was a blank, and not inspiring, not anything, until she started taking me like to the Museum of Art, and she would show me picture figures like the my Kuan Yin. They were beautiful Chinese statues, and there were several of them. And she said, "Oh my," she said, "you can look at this one and know they're cooking cabbage down the hall." And she doesn't like it very much because she was, you know, of her expression. And then she said, "In this one, you can tell she's standing out in a yard with beautiful blooms and plants all around." And so she gave me a feeling for looking at something in something beautiful. And doing your own interpretation. This one is my favorite.
13th or 14th
century. Mm-hmm. And that he's unevolved. And he's just a sweet man. And to do the hand, I've never drawn hands before. So what I did is, and I couldn't draw my right hand, which that is his right hand. So I took my left hand and put it over here and tried to copy it. I'm into doing drawings of this type sitting. And I started doing it when a doctor friend who lived here in the at the Breakers passed away. And I wanted a picture of him. So if you can wait for a minute.
Well, sure. What's her name?
Maxine.
Maxine.
Uh-huh. Now, Maxine always had curly hair. So she would do her hair in little spit curls like this. And so I put lace around her neck. So when I put the background in, see how much the background means to the painting? She has another daughter and a son. And this is the two of us when she got married.
Wow. Look at my aunt was a ravishing beauty then.
All right. And this
she is.
Incredible, huh?
This was her husband.
Oh, wow. How beautiful.
I want to see you.
And by the way, my mother made that wedding, bridesmaid dress for me in one day. And I paid 12 cents a yard for the fabric. And this is what I wrote this and had it reproduced into each of her children and grandchildren. I sent a picture. And then I said, this is a sketch of Maxine as I remember her over the years. Reaching back into high school days, including being her bridesmaid as she exchanged wedding vows with Kenny Bredemeyer, future father of their three children, Louise, Judy, and Chuck. A span of over 70 years, corresponding with intervals along the way, sharing happy times in each other's company in Minneapolis or Los Angeles. This picture is a simplistic attempt to capture her spirit and the loved person, I can barely read this, she will always be, and share with you my feelings of the Maxine who smiles to me through my heart while letting me draw her likeness using 6 colored pencils. To fill in the background, I found an old bottle of black ink and I brushed it in, tapering it off at the ends so it was not solid. In that tapering, to my surprise, the sailing ships unintentionally formed at the bottom of the picture. to reproduce the drawing for all of us to share, I used the Xerox machine. My love, Auril Thompson. Someone that I know. 1944. And,
wow.
And him in 19... Oh, that's how old he was.
Yeah, okay.
I didn't do him then. And
this was last year.
I made the original at that time. And this is Nancy. Did you get that?
Yeah.
I did like a nightmare dream.
Have you seen this one, Karen?
Yeah.
Wow.
This is before I put the color in it.
Yeah. Oh, they're both Cody.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is
okay.
Cody in her little blondness. She's all eyes and cuteness. This is as she's grown older. This is more like a, not a caricature, but not a real profile. And then there was another one of Ashley. If you turn the page, I think you'll find. There's Ashley.
This is my cousin and my aunt's daughter, so her youngest child. And this is Nancy's eldest child, Ashley.
Beautiful.
And these two are Cody, Nancy's youngest child.
Beautiful.
That was my life's work.
Okay.
The animation art. This is just something that I have done since I've been just alone. And love it very much, and it's just something that's developed.
Okay.
It's so things that I remember. And
what year you started working as an artist, like painting?
This
yes.
was, since I've been here, I would say about 3 years ago.
3 years ago
doctor,
you started?
No longer was here, I wanted to do a picture to have of him for his family, which are wonderful. And so I just started gingerly doing a few things, creeping and crawling, and finally getting on my knees and then getting up and walking. And I still have a ways to go. And I enjoy every minute of it. And but I've destroyed my eyesight by sitting maybe, sitting down after breakfast and thinking, oh, I'm going to make a little sketch of this. And then I'll get ready for lunch. And I look at my watch when I get through making the sketch, because it goes on and on and on and on and on, and it's 2:30 in the afternoon. So I've spent all of that time not moving from the chair. And that's how gripping drawing can be. And it's like anyone, if they're in a profession, if they're into music, or things of that, songwriting, anything. They'll stay up all night or two nights working on it and loving it and not feeling pressure or anything. You just feel like you're aglow with something. And it's fun doing, and it's fun seeing what has come out. Because you don't start with this picture in your mind. You start with the eyes, and then put the ears in so that you know where the balance of the head is, and then get the nose in. Maybe you change the nose 4 or 5 times while you're drawing. Get the mouth underneath it, and maybe you start out with a little smile, and then maybe afterwards you take the smile off. So it's fun doing.
If I were a painter, I would paint my reverie. If that's the only way for you to be with me.